Hello, friends. Do you fantasize about building websites or apps for a living? Do you dream in JavaScript? Were you born to code? If the answer to any of these questions is a resounding yes, then it was pretty smart of you to sign up for AP Computer Science A. Of course, taking the course also means that you'll face the AP exam itself, and lucky for you, I'm going to talk about that very test in this very video. What an insane coincidence! You may be watching this because the AP exams are changing as of May 2020. While the AP Computer Science A exam won't be changing as dramatically as some of its counterparts, there would be some changes to the free response questions, or FRQs for short. In the new version, the four FRQs will consist of four specific types: method and control structures, class, ArrayList, and 2D array. Also, the FRQs will now measure various performance levels, unlike before when all FRQs were high level. More on that all later on. For now, here's a little rundown of what you can expect come May. For starters, the Computer Science A exam is a tidy 3 hours. Thankfully, it is also given at a humane hour of noon. The exam consists of multiple choice and free response questions. Each section is an hour and a half long and accounts for 50% of your score. The multiple choice section will contain 40 questions in all. While most of these will be individual questions, you'll definitely encounter a few sets, 2 to 3 questions each. The multiple choice questions typically cover the following computational thinking practices: program design and algorithmic development, wherein you'll have to determine the code segments necessary to generate a given output. This will account for roughly 30 to 35% of the section. Code logic, wherein you'll have to figure out the value, output, and result of a given program code from the initial given values. Folks, this will account for roughly 40 to 45% of the section. Code testing, wherein you'll be asked to analyze code for errors, correctness, and/or equivalence. This will account for roughly 12 to 18% of the section. Documentation, wherein you'll need to describe the conditions and behaviors that will produce a program's identified results. This will account for roughly 12 to 18% of the section. Ready to move to the free response section? I hope so, because here we go. In this section, you'll be asked to answer 4 questions. They'll all have to do with code implementation. More specifically, question 1 is all about methods and control structures. You'll have to write a program in which you create objects of a class and call methods. What's more, you'll need to satisfy method specifications using conditional statements, iterative statements, and expressions. Question 2 will address classes. Be ready to write a program code that defines a new type by creating a class. And once again, you'll have to satisfy method specifications using conditional statements, iterative statements, and expressions. Question 3 covers ArrayList. Yet again, you'll have to write a code that satisfied method specifications using conditional statements, iterative statements, and expressions. But there's more. You'll also be expected to create, traverse, and manipulate elements in either 1D array or ArrayList objects. Finally, the moment you've all been waiting for, we've arrived at question 4, which is all about 2D array. And as you might have guessed, not only will you need to write a program code that satisfies method specifications using conditional statements, iterative statements, and expressions, but it will also have to create, traverse, and manipulate elements, this time in 2D array objects. Folks, if you're anxious to start kicking your test prep into high gear, we have got great news for you. We here at the Princeton Review have released a fully updated for 2020 Cracking the AP Computer Science A Exam Guidebook, complete with 2 free practice tests and all the content review that you'll need, and it's available wherever books are sold right now. As always, be sure to subscribe to our channel. We're always updating it with new videos to stay on top of the latest developments in the AP land.